President Trump just responded to sex assault allegations from a former Apprentice contestant who accuses Trump of kissing and groping her back in 2007. Summer Zervos' lawyer has now subpoenaed President Trump's campaign for any documents that he has related to her or to any woman who claims that they were touched inappropriately. I want to bring in two criminal defense attorneys, Sara Azari and Yodit Tewolde. Sara, when you look at this and this subpoena, just walk us through how this could play out, what the campaign would have to provide, if there's a way for them to get out of this, and if the president could ultimately even be deposed.
Right, so this lawsuit was filed January of this year, and then the subpoena was issued in March, but compliance with the subpoena was actually put over until Trump's lawyers file and have heard a motion to dismiss. So if that motion to dismiss is actually granted, I think it's going to get heard in October, then the subpoena dies with that lawsuit. However, I don't think that's going to happen. I think what's going to happen is, as the law stands, lawsuits can be brought against presidents for conduct that does not have anything to do with their presidency and their official capacity. But because it takes time away from them doing their job and leading the country, often these lawsuits are stayed until the president is done with his term. And so I think at best that's probably what's going to happen here. And the issue with the subpoena itself is a separate issue because the validity of that subpoena, it's a court order, essentially. It's the same thing as a court ordering the other party to produce documents or testimony. The problem that I see with the subpoena that the court might actually see as well is that it is a little bit too broad. You cannot go on a fishing expedition through a subpoena. It has to be relevant. It has to identify a time period. You can't just ask for any woman's accusations against Trump from the beginning of time. So if this subpoena is invalidated, it can just be reissued and it can be rewritten, you know, the declaration in support of it. In a narrower way, where there's a time period that's specified, there may be specific women that are named, and then the relevance has to be set forth. You know, why is it that these other women's allegations are relevant to Zervos' allegations? You know, there's no precedent for this. Trump has 75 or so lawsuits pending against him that he's going to have to deal with one day. And many of these are brought in state court because these are state cases, misconduct that's subject to state law in different states, you know, California, New York. I believe this one was filed in New York. But nonetheless, if the court allows this to proceed during Trump's presidency, then that's a huge precedent for the other 74 lawsuits or however many there are, and future presidents who may be subject to lawsuits for misconduct.